Hey everybody, welcome back. My name is Everett Mohan, also known as Aspiring Spike on the internet. Today I'm recording with one of my favorite decks to play in Modern right now. That's Jund Sacrifice. This is a brew of mine that I put together a few weeks ago, and I've spent a lot of time on and off stream working on the list. I've written a deck guide for this list on CFB Pro, but I haven't gotten around to recording with it for Channel Fireball, so I wanted to do that today. I've been really, really impressed by this deck. You know, the big idea here is that Goblin Bombardment is one of the most powerful cards from Modern Horizons 1 that hadn't really been seeing any play. And I think it's a pretty difficult card to build around, because you would think that to play a card like Goblin Bombardment, which is, for those of you who don't know, a 2-mana enchantment that you can sacrifice a creature and deal 1 damage to any target, maybe the best sacrifice outlet in all of Magic's history. You would think that you would have to play like Stitcher's Applier, Gravecrawler, you just kind of like lower impact cards that don't really hold their own in the Modern format. And I don't think that you have to build a deck that way. There are a lot of really powerful Modern staples that work well together and also work really well when you have Bombardment. So the idea here is that this is just a good value Jund deck that is really powerful when it draws Bombardment, has a lot of synergies, but a lot of the threats are kind of individually powerful. And building the deck this way allows you to fight through Graveyard Hate really well, fight through removal spells really well, and also, you know, kill your opponent out of nowhere sometimes with Bombardment and Mayhem Devil, where Garrus and Seasoned Pyromancer are two of the best three mana threats in the format. Both cards fill up your graveyard really quickly, and power up cards like Bloodgas, Kroxa, Collected Company is excellent in a deck with so many 3-drops and is a really, really good value card. Kroxa is a very strong way to grind through the very removal-heavy format. It's a good card, again, to discard a Seasoned Pyromancer. And it also triggers Mayhem Devil when you play Kroxa. I've been super impressed by Mayhem Devil. Like, your opponent, just a format full of Fetchlands, Mishra's Baubles, Chromatic Stars, Expedition Maps. Mayhem Devil gets triggered a lot. This card is actually just a pretty, pretty strong card. Bloodgast is kind of like maybe like the one card in this deck that is a little bit weak on its own, but it is also a card that's like pretty good against removal spells. It has a lot of synergy with Seasoned Pyromancer, and it's very good with Goblin Bombardment, where you sac Bloodgast, you ping, you play a land, maybe a fetch land, and you just return your Bloodgast over and over again and can either control the board or kill your opponent with a lot of pings. We're also playing Ragavan and Ignoble Hierarch. We're mostly playing these cards for mana acceleration, but Ragavan specifically is really nice in this deck, where it ramps you into your 3-drops, but it also is just a really good threat when your opponent plays Rest in Peace or something like that. You just keep hitting them with Ragavan, which is really, really nice. And the treasure tokens actually trigger Mayhem Devil too, which is pretty cool. And then Unearth is also very good in a deck full of sac outlets and discard outlets and 3-drops. Sideboard, we have Fulminator Mage, which is very good in our Collected Company Unearth deck against big mana decks, Endurance against Graveyard strategies, and just Ragavan, Murktide, Channeler decks in general. Culling Ritual has been an all-star. Really, really good addition to the sideboard. Kind of techie. Very, very good against Hammer Time. Just totally swings that matchup around. Can get you out of some really sticky situations. Good against Hammer Time too, but mostly for the Hammer Time matchup. And then Force of Vigor is also for Hammer Time, and then various artifacts and enchantments of the format. I like this card against Titan as well. Very good against killing Amulets, Sagas, Dryad of the Elysian Groves, and then a couple of sideboard cards for the Cascade matchups. Again, I've been really, really impressed by this deck. I think it's really, really strong, but it is definitely one that is difficult to pilot perfectly and takes a lot of time to master. I know that when I was starting to play the deck, it did take me a while before I felt like I was really playing it masterfully. So hopefully I can showcase what that looks like here today. Okay, we are on the play for the first match of this league. Opponent has revealed Lurrus of the Dream Den. 2 Ragavans, but no red mana. Ignoble Hierarch, but no green mana. 1 land anyways. All right. When you mold a 5, Ren and 6 is like maybe like the card you want to see more than anything else. It's a great mold of five. Oh, my opponent's also gone to five. Okay, cool, cool. Yeah, this is great. Like, assuming Ren and Six lives, like, this is just a seven card hand. Like, we'll just get those two lands we put away right back. Interesting. So let's see if they kill my Ragavan. Surprise, surprise. So I guess they're playing some kind of burn variant, which I haven't found to be a very good matchup. But they did mold a five, and I have found Ragavan to be pretty good against burn, where it's just a one mana card that kind of just it demands to be killed by a removal spell. I think they have Eidolon in there, just tapping here. Eidolon's pretty good here. Although, we'll see if they are feeling brave enough to not block, because I've got a lot of cards I can hit off Ragavan to just kill their Eidolon. That being said, maybe I should just cast so I could block. Oof. That is best possible, huh? Let's get my second basic mountain. This way I can also get a card back with Ruin. Best possible must be nice, huh? I guess it is nice. I don't know who I'm asking. It is nice. Can maybe ultimate the Ren, get infinite unearths. Shock in the Sacred Foundry. Got a floating red mana. Not sure what they want to do with it. They said Lava Spike B. Then oops all monkeys. I would love for this to eat a removal spell. Does not. They're down to 11. Swift Spear. It's interesting. I wonder if I should just ping them. Yeah, I don't know. I feel like we're in a racing situation. This might end up doing like a crucial three points of damage here. Boros Charm me down to 10. Yeah, I feel like that's kind of a bold ping, but I think it makes sense to me. Okay, Kroxa is interesting. Let me Ragavan first. We don't really have nearly enough cards to escape Kroxa, but we might be able to go like, oh, I guess I could have gone Kroxa, Unearth, Kroxa, Trigger Prowess. That might have been good. Although with them as being at six, the numbers probably aren't that relevant. I guess they're relevant with the Ren and Six ping. Helix would be a lot better for my opponent here. Yeah, they go down to three, and then they have to Sunbaked Canyon, and lose a life, and they have to draw a spell to not die, and then they have to discard that spell. So they're in really bad shape here. Yeah, they just concede. I haven't found the burn matchup again to be that good, but you do have some draws that are good against them. I do think sometimes they bring in Rest in Peace, but Eidolon is also like a big pain against you, so I'd like to have at least two Force of Vigors. And then I think Culling Ritual is usually a bit slow, but Mayhem Devil is also kind of bad, being three toughness. So I usually like to go down two Mayhem Devils, two Blood Gas, one Bombardment, bring in three Endurance, and then I have 25 hits for Coco, which is about the bare minimum. Oh, these Ren and Sixes are also pretty bad. Maybe I should actually be going down one Ren and Six, can keep in three Blood Ghasts, or maybe keep in the fourth Bombardment. Guess Blood Ghasts are worse, like the less Bombardments we have. I think I'll just play the third Mayhem Devil. If they kill it, then that's not a burn spell. It's going towards our face. I think I have to mulligan this. My opponent kept seven this time. No fair. It's probably getting Overgrown Tomb on turn one. I guess we could draw something that would change your mind on that. OK, Okay, it's kind of nice to have an answer to Eidolon. I think I'm getting overgrown to no matter what here, so I'm just going to fetch before the Goblin Guide trigger resolves. Because if they reveal Overgrown Tomb, it's kind of a disaster. Verdant Catacombs instead. Thank you, Goblin Guide. No Eidolon, which I think is probably bad for us with this hand, to be honest. Cast Kroxa. Kroxa is pretty good in this matchup, usually. It is nice that our hand was somewhat painless, but, you know, we all know that just taking 6 damage from Goblin Guide is usually not a winning exchange. And down to 9, a very, very crucial 9 points of life. They might just have 3 one mana burn spells now. Seems like they don't. Okay, so we do get to Seasoned Pyromancer here. I think I'm going to discard the Ignoble Hierarch. And I actually can't fetch any basic that lets me cast Kroxa, so I'll just discard the Verdant Catacombs. I kind of just need our opponent to draw an Eidolon, so that's just like uses their mana in a way that doesn't kill me and lets me force a vigor. They're drawing a card off Canyon, just likely to be dead at any moment, but not dead now. So what's our best plan here? Obviously my opponent's hand has no burn spells, so I feel like casting these Kroxas is probably not gonna accomplish that much this turn, especially, or at least casting a Kroxa that's not escaped. So I guess I'll just main phase Coco. And maybe if we find Mayhem Devil, we can just kill them next turn. Grist will let me escape this Kroxa. Yeah, I think if we draw a Mayhem Devil, again, we've got lethal next turn. But beyond that, it's not looking too good. And they have another Canyon, so they have to, like, they have to break on 2 more draw steps for burn. I've seen it happen, but I'd be kind of surprised to untap again. The third Canyon. You guys remember? Burn was such a different deck before I got these Canyons. But we're alive. I have 3 cards in their hand, though. It's going to be really hard to beat 3 cards here. Our top card is Ragavan. If anyone can do it, Ragavan can. Since we can maybe just find like a Helix. Any chance we can deal 14? Maybe if I hit Bloodghast, we can deal 14. Didn't hit Bloodghast. We can go Bombardment, Kroxa, that's 4 damage. Dash Ragavan. 5 more, down to 9. Sack 4. I think we're actually just 1 short. It's assuming they discard a land for the Kroxa, by the way. Yeah, let me just dash Ragavan. We could still technically make that line post-combat, and then... Oh, this doesn't have haste. But I guess if they discard a land to Kroxa, and we hit a 1-mana burn spell off Ragavan... Sanctifier. Well, that's a really good one to know about. I guess I have to bring in Culling Ritual for game 3 if we, you know, if we somehow survive another turn or don't survive another turn. I'll just escape Kroxa. You know what's kind of sad though is that Ragavan just like. It did just get a brick off the top of my opponent's library. It did discard a land too. Oh, man. Are we somehow still alive? It's like the fourth canon. You can't write this, man. This is crazy. Okay, good. I would have felt so dirty losing or so dirty winning this game. Oof, that was so weird. Yeah, let me bring in the color rituals on the play. They're better on the play anyways. Maybe I'll play one Force of Vigor. No Ren and six. Yeah, let's do this. They bricked for so long. If we hadn't attacked with Ragavan, I think we win. It's kind of funny how that works out sometimes. Things are definitely a lot better on the play, but I do still think this matchup's pretty bad. But you can win your bad matchups, and you can lose your good ones. Okay, on the play for game three, let's go. Okay, I mentioned this earlier, but turn one monkey, very important in this matchup. Where, like, they just have to kill it. You know, their deck is full of cheap spells for Ragavan to cast, and, you know, we're a red deck, so they have to kill it. Especially on the play, too, they only have Lightning Bolt to kill it, too, which is a big problem for them. And here, if they kill it, I'm going to Unearth. And I think we do it off of the Overgrown Tomb, so we can cast Endurance next turn. And, you know, just trading one for one against Burn is really nice. Guess I'll turn off my auto yields. If my opponent casts Eidolon, I'll probably Force of Vigor. They have Searing Blaze instead, which is very good. Hopefully they play a haste creature here. That would be a nice break. Be a really nice break. Not a haste creature. I don't think I can afford to not play Endurance here. It might be fine to try to ambush next turn, but just so much better for our curve to go Endurance into Coco here. I'm not sure about the main phase Coco. Maybe it was better to try to ambush, but Main phase is usually where I'm at in this version that plays Grist. All right, 12. They've got four cards in their hand. Okay. I'm so happy to see double Eidolon. I can't believe my luck. I can't believe my luck with my Force of Vigor in my hand. All right, I'm going to attack with both my Endurances, and then maybe they like double block Endurance or something. Maybe I should just leave the Eidolons in play. I don't know. I don't know. I thought they might double block with Sanctifier. I don't know why they would do that. I think I just messed up. Yeah, I guess I just messed up, because why would they ever block like that? And I could have just put them to one or made them chip block with Sanctifier. Yeah, I guess I got a little greedy there. But the Force of Vigor coming through incredibly well there. I can't believe my opponent played two Eidolons. I'm so lucky. So lucky. They sack the canyon. We're at 12 life. Very healthy life total. Plays a Goblin Guide. Can they attack? Or do they feel like they can attack? Remember, this Mayhem Devil triggers off of these fetch lands. But I'm just going to Coco. Grist, another Endurance. And they just pack it up. Okay. Well, pretty bad matchup I found, but just like any bad matchup in Magic, if you just play well and your deck's good, you'll win a decent amount of the time. On the draw for round number two, we're playing against a Lurrus deck again. Last round was also Lurrus with Burn. I'm gonna keep, I think. My opponent's still deciding. But if this is one of the more grindy Lurrus decks, then this is a keepable hand. If it's hammer time, this hand's not that good. And no matter what, we're kind of soft to Ragavan, but we're on the draw. Most of our hands are pretty bad against Ragavan anyways. Okay, they've decided to keep seven. They are playing hammer time. Drum go, okay. Guess I'm gonna save these fetch lands to trigger Mayhem Devil. Yeah, definitely a slow hand against hammer time. Sometimes they keep pretty slow hands too though, these days. Their deck is like very grindy, resilient to removal. Really not the fastest way to build the deck. Which is good news for us right now. They get hammer and they cast hammer, which is bad news for us because that means they almost definitely have a paladin in their hand. Usually, they either have a paladin or they have like two more hammers. They're just getting one in play. Maybe two more hammers is good news for us. Discard a Stoneforge Mystic, which does significantly reduce the possibility that they just have two more hammers. Dead to one more hammer. It's 21 damage, we're at 20, we're done. Thankfully, however, we've got this pile of Culling Rituals to bring in. Culling Ritual, very, very good against them. They usually bring in a lot of Sanctifier and Vex too, which is, you know, Culling Ritual's the best answer to those. Usually I cut the fourth Coco for mana curve considerations, fourth Bombardment, three Bloodghasts, two Crooxes, two Bloodghasts. Maybe leave it the fourth Bombardment, but it is a bit awkward with Ritual. But it is a really good card in the matchup, but usually when I bring in the Rituals, I like to cut the fourth Bombardment. I could see maybe changing my mind on that and cutting like the second Bloodghast or the third Bloodghast. Lost match one with 16 seconds on my clock used. Waiting on my opponent to reveal Lurrus. They decide to yet again reveal Lurrus.
I feel that I can keep this on the play. Ren and Six ping is pretty good if they're on Esper Sentinel or Midnight on turn one. It's not great against Sentinel, I guess, but it does get to kill the Sentinel, but they get to draw a card. Good against Smith on two, maybe. Although sometimes they have a zero drop. Give her two toughness, but big bummer. I guess I'll just play High Arc. Hand's way better if we have High Arc on one, then we get to go Spyro, discard Ren and Six. Spyro, maybe, or Ren and Six land. Uh-oh. I could play Ren and Six and just get some blockers down. Or sorry, Seasoned Pyromancer, get some blockers down. Yeah, I kind of like Seasoned Pyromancer, discard Seasoned Pyromancer, Ren and Six. Play another High Arc. And I like getting a green and red blockers here so they can't just go like hammer. Give Pro Red, tech through everything. They can still give Pro Red, I guess, and make me chump with the High Arc, but then I get to Grist kill the Midmites because they've tapped their Giver. Obviously, if they just naturally have Shadow Spear, it's bad. If they have Stoneforge Mystic plus land for Shadow Spear, it's bad, but good block. Yeah, we are did to Shadow Spear plus Hammer, but yeah, thankfully we were able to narrowly dodge it, huh? So Calling Ritual or Force of Vigor are both phenomenal draws. They do reveal Shadow Spear. Right, so I guess what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna dash Ragavan. And then I want my opponent to give the Stoneforge Mystic protection from red. So I can just minus on the Midnight. So they just chump block, which makes sense. But then we get to go Grist, kill Giver. I'll sack the elemental token. And then likely, we should be able to kill the Midmite with the Grist next turn. We even technically survive another hammer, right? 22. Oh no, we go to exactly zero if they have another hammer. I guess we could have tried to play around that by sacking a High Arc. I don't know how much we want to play in that game, but it's probably fine. I don't think they've had another hammer. Maybe they have. We just used another hammer. Never lost anything before. Yeah, dead. Maybe that was not as good. I'm not sure. We have to sack a High Arc. And then we have to like chump with two creatures. But then we're also like we're probably winning this game even at one life. Don't know. I don't know. Either way, we're 1-1. Maybe mistakes were made that game. But I'll see you guys in round number three. Okay, we are on the play for round number three. Another mulligan. I feel like we've been mulliganing a lot this league. Very red hand. Let's keep. We'll play the monkey on turn one. Both of our basic bounces. This looks like just such a different deck. This hand's totally fine though if we get to connect with Ragavan. My opponent, didn't reveal a companion. Arid Mace with no companion is interesting. Could be burned with no Luris. Prismatic Ending, okay. It's a great draw. Let's play our Bombardment here. So Sacred Foundry, Prismatic Ending, no companion. Bloodstained Mire. Some kind of brew. This Mayhem Devil is pretty fragile here. It does use our mana pretty well. And I guess I could have maybe played around Blood Moon by getting Swamp. I don't know. I think I'll just get got by Blood Moon. Our hand's pretty good against Blood Moon, too. If we draw land, we get to go just cast Ragavan, cast Seasoned Pyromancer. Oh, I shouldn't be F6, though, because if they bolt by Mayhem Devil, I'll just kill them, too. Mardu Triome. So unlikely to get Blood Moon. No Lightning Bolt is great for us. Jeskai Triumph. So maybe some kind of zoo deck? Maybe. No, this is creativity. It's creativity. With all the red fetch lands. You could tell. You know what? Mayhem Devil's pretty good against creativity. Where they get Emrakul in play, and then they attack you and they just die because Mayhem Devil triggers a million times. So they can just cast the second Mayhem Devil. They didn't have a Lightning Bolt last turn either. They play a lot of fetch lands, so this is like likely to do them too. And they're also dead next turn if they don't have anything with a Seasoned Pyromancer. Some kind of hybrid reanimator deck, creativity deck. Pretty interesting. They don't discard an Archon of Cruelty or any creature for that matter. So gotta be pretty happy about. Take two. Yeah, so I think they're dead if we draw. I mean, I think they're, assuming they have nothing, I think they lose, but we get extra damage if you draw a spell to discard a Seasoned Pyromancer or a fetch land to trigger the devils. Oh, I guess with this draw, I'll just go. Just cast the Ragavan. It's the same amount of damage. Yeah, but this is three damage. It's three damage, three damage. Attack, three more damage. I think we put them to -2. And I'm really happy we saw the bindings, because I don't know if I would have brought in these endurances if I hadn't seen them. I might bring in mages on the play. I think they're a little slow in the draw in this matchup. Let me cut the Renin sixes. And then, oh, maybe I want to cut both Kroxos since they're reanimating. Yeah. Wait, one Renin, I guess? Seems fine. Go to discard, Unearth Mayhem Devil on two. Let's send this one back. I feel like on the draw in this matchup, I'd really like to have a one drop. Maybe I should have finished that thought. I'm gonna keep back Bloodghast. It's good if we draw lands, good if Ragavan's connects. I don't think they're playing Renin 6. I think that they're four colors, non-red. Sorry, non-green. I think Endurance, you know, obviously stops there. Reanimation plans. I feel like this is fine. Dash Monkey. Oh, worried we get both of our monkeys killed. We really needed this to connect at least once, because now we're just in a spot where. Okay, I'm gonna play it. I'm really surprised they brought it in. Well, it's Curse of Silence them, and then what do we name? Faithful Mending? Could name Creativity. Yeah, I guess we're like insulated against Mending with Endurance, Mending Persist. Just making their creativities cost two more seems fine here. Maybe it's just a Teferi. Not sure. Obviously, a lot of choices there. Hard evidence. Good against Monkey. Let's play out the Bloodghast. It's like they're casting the Minion. They do discard Archon, which I have Endurance to stop. Sorry for leaving the mic. Maybe this just debated me into losing my very valuable green mana. But I would have been yelled at, of course, for not casting the sweet Curse of Silence. Gotta test the new cards, huh? The Flashback Mending. Discard Blood Crypt and Bloodstained Mire. So I guess they were kind of flooded. It's fine. You just rattle off a couple lands in a row. Okay, that at least makes it to where if we rattle off one land, we're going to be starting to do stuff. Yes, and they've got these clue tokens. They can also cast creativity now. Right, we do get to endurance, which is nice. This is something we maybe needed to have happen. I can't imagine that makes a lot of their deck worse. Now, can I just please find a land? It's been we've gone a long time without a land. There we go. Get the Bloodghast back. And I think I'll keep a Collected Company. Okay, things are maybe turning around. So if they creativity, it's only X1 unless they have another land. Then it's X2. But it seems like they don't have it. That's main phase. I'm not sure how many counters they have against us post board, but we're a Grist deck. Playing around Mayhem Devil, love to see it. You basically never see it. But maybe people are finally learning. And the Grist is going to give us some insulation against Imrakul, at least. Maybe not so much Velimachus. Totally fine with that trade. That's a lot of damage, huh? Kind of baiting counterspell here with Ren. Pretty sure they're dead. I'm not gonna do the math, I'm just gonna attack first. I guess plussing is, oh no. Yeah, I guess maybe plussing was correct first so I could sack the Bloodghast to get my land. All right, so now let's do the math. 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I guess that was easy math. Not lethal. Should I kill these crabs? I think let's kill these crabs, yeah. We can plus and pick up the bloodstained mire that we milled with grist, get back our blood gas. They definitely don't have creativity in their hand since they let my curse of silence stay around. If they get a Dwarven Embodiment token, I'm gonna ping the token instead of getting the mire back. Just because, like, assuming they don't chump block. They do chump block. Interesting. Did they just board out creativities? Is that, like, a cyborg plan? It's kind of a weird cyborg plan. The last card was fire. I'm not really worried about. It's a really weird game. I feel like I say that a lot these days. Modern's kind of all over the place, but in a good way, in my opinion. Format's really diverse. People are kind of doing whatever they want. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So minusing Grist is equal to 6 damage because Grist does count itself in the graveyard. Let me cast this first. Okay, well, can't imagine that they survived this. Okay, 2-1. I'll see you guys in round number 4. I like this hand a lot. We're on the play for match number 4. Easy keep. Opponent's deciding if they want to keep or mulligan. No companion over there. Don't need to read too much into that, but you know, definitely when you see Lurrus, there's a lot of decks that you need to start thinking about, and then we don't see Lurrus, there's like the other half of the format that you start thinking about. Yeah, I want to dash Ragavan here so I have access to Coco next turn. It also like kind of looks like I'm not Junsak leading on Mountain ending, or sorry. It's Prismatic, as Prisma, and I just thought Prismatic ending. Prismari Command is interesting. Not sure exactly what that says. I think I go for Bombardment into Dash Ragavan if this resolves or doesn't resolve. And then I think into just the open mana, I'll just play this tapped. The jig is up now that I played the Bombardment, I think. Thought Scour. You know, this could just be Blue Red Murktide. Like, Nassif, Gabriel Nassif, you know, personal hero, member of CFB Pro. Has been popularizing a main deck engineered explosives in Blue Red Murktide as kind of a way to hedge against Chalice of the Void, Rhinos, and Hammer Time. And Prismari Command doesn't hedge against Rhinos, but it is good against Hammer Time and Chalice, and it also being an instant gives you more synergy in the deck than explosives does, because it's good, it's better with Murktide, maybe better with DRC. So they could just be playing regular old Blue Red Murktide and be playing a Prismari Command in the main. And they could also potentially be playing just Blue Moon. And I think seeing this second, oh, you know what? Someone in my chat said this the other day. If you see the Theros Islands, it's Blue Moon. I think I'm kind of inclined to agree. Well, I've had better collected companies. And of course, I've had worse. Had better, had worse. Kind of expect Dragonman to die. What? Was that a. Did they miss with their lightning bolt? They bolted my blood gas? They made a relic? They're stealing. Well, I mean, this isn't very good against my bombardment, right? They have, like, spell snare? Yeah, I think they got blinded by the Archmage's Charm's very powerful ability to steal a permanent. I definitely have been too sometimes. Getting Griston play is great as well. They don't have Delirium for Unholy Heat. Not that they're definitely playing Heat, sometimes Blue Beam doesn't. Mismatched Scalding Tarns. Shocks and Steam Vents. They must need double red for something if they're going to shock Steam Vents at this point in the game. Yeah, I feel like Blue Moon players tend to really gravitate towards this basic island. It's kind of like this is obviously not scientific or 100% true, but I kind of feel like Eldrazi Tron players tend to play white border Tron lands and green Tron players tend to play black border ones. That might just be like confirmation bias when you see it, you notice it, but I've noticed it. Okay, they're gonna respond to my Grist plus one. To deal one damage to insect, one damage to Grist while ping, sacking the insect. Don't really know why this is happening now, though. They could have killed my Grist. I think that they don't realize the extra loyalty is already on the Grist. This is maybe something that newer players have to learn. I mean, it is something newer players have to learn, but the plus one happens as part of the cost. It doesn't happen. The loyalty doesn't go on the Planeswalker after the resolution of the ability, which is maybe like more intuitively how you would think it would work. But either way, if they want to kill my Grist this turn, they should have done it. Even if it did work that way, it would have been better for them to not let me get the extra plant. But it doesn't work that way either. I didn't find anything off Ragavan. Usually against decks like Blue Red that can't really answer Bombardment, and I already have one in play, I'll just hold the second copy to discard the Seasoned Pyromancer for a token. Okay, confirmed Blue Moon, although I was pretty sure already. And we're pretty well set up against Blood Moon. We've got a Swamp, we've got a Treasure, got a Grist, got Blood Gas in the yard. Oh, got a Season. Yeah, a lot of stuff going on here. And even I can get back those Seasoned Pyromancer tokens. I think my opponent's dead if they don't have anything. Probably dead even if they have something. Guess let's use this for two damage rather than the tokens. Right. One game one. I think we probably still would have won even if my opponent didn't mess up there with the fire and the bolt. I'm bringing these endurances, I think. Pretty resilient to removal, good against Murktide, or can hedge against Murktide. It's kind of double. Bombardment four. This is usually how I side when I bring in endurances. I cut the blood gas, I cut a bombardment. But I feel like blood gas are pretty good against their deck. He'll cut a Kroxa. It'd be kind of hard to cast through Blood Moon. Although Kroxa is pretty good against them too. Tough one. A Ragavan on the draw. The one mana spells are kind of at a premium. Unearth is good. I guess I'll cut the Blood Gas, number four. Think get rid of the card is too important. I don't want to go down to just two Mayhem Devils, but I could, I suppose. I think I want to keep three. Okay. I don't think I'd keep this hand against every deck, but I'll keep this against Blue Moon pretty easily. And then on turn two, if my opponent is representing counter magic, I'm going to play Blood Gas. And if they're representing not counter magic somehow, I'll play the Bombardment. And sometimes their deck plays their deck does play Fire Ice here. So what I want to do to play around Fire Ice is wait to crack the fetch land until my turn. Because if they ice me on my upkeep and I don't get to play anything, it's kind of a disaster. And they're a control deck. Our life total is relevant. They've got Murktide Regent, but seems good to me. Pretty full graveyard. We can kill a Murktide Regent with Grist. They play that this turn. It is nice that they can't like spell pierce Grist. Let me attack with Blood Ghast. Probably just gonna play another Blood Ghast. And play Verdant Catacombs because I would like the ability to get a basic island or sorry forest force of habit basic forest in case my opponent Blood Moons me. Yeah, Lightning Bolt on Blood Ghast is definitely a victory for us. Basic forest crooks are definitely a little bit of tension. Oh, not that big a deal. Remember when I sided out of Blood Ghast? I don't know. Not sure what I was supposed to do instead, but kind of wish I had all four back in. They look really good here. Though this looks like a Murktide Regent with Counterspell up. Eat. So let's get Stomping Ground tapped. Get back a Blood Ghast. Have a head scratcher of a turn. I think my opponent's going to counter the bombardment and then I'm going to play Hierarch, but I want to play this before my land just in case they don't. Yeah. You're just getting the counter or a counter spell out of their hand is really important here. So that next turn, we can maybe go two drop into Grist, kill Murktide. If they counter my Grist, we probably lose. Murktide is so big. Bolts the Hierarch. Two cards left in hand. Guess I'm attacking first. They do counterspell. That's in most things. We beat non-creature counterspells. We beat like Spell Pierce. Bummer. They maneuvered that game pretty well. All right. I guess we want this fourth Blood Ghast back in. Let me cut the. It just gotta be me and then number three, unfortunately. It's a little too fragile to bolts, and then I think it makes sense for mana curve considerations too. We're on the play. I think I like this hand well enough to keep it against Blue Moon. I'd really prefer to have a one drop, but this hand is pretty good against Blood Moon. It has answers to Murktide Regents. We're on the play. Definitely not a hand I'm like thrilled to have, but one that I also don't feel like I can mulligan. I do want to potentially get, you know, swamp with this Bloodstained Mire, so see what we draw here and carefully consider which land we'll be playing next. And that one's kind of a headache, because that one really doesn't incentivize me to get swamp. I'll just play this, and maybe we'll draw another red fetch. Just have an easy choice. Wouldn't that be nice, huh? Easy choice. Ice would be kind of a disaster. I'd almost rather than just have counterspell for my Grist. Doesn't seem like they're that likely to Blood Moon, right? Yeah, I guess I'll just get Stomping Ground. Just makes my mana so much easier. And I can just Endurance, maybe after they cast some cantrips here. Okay, I don't need to upkeep the Endurance. Would have maybe upkeeped it if they had cast like Considered Thoughtscour or something. And I guess if they do jam Blood Moon, I'll just get a Swamp. They main phased fetched. It's kind of weird, right? They're playing something. Okay, they have to have Blood Moon here. I don't think anybody can bluff a Blood Moon that well. Where I think it's just like they want it, they have Blood Moon, and they realize their Blood Moon is just not that good for them here because I've got the Mire. And so they're just waiting. Because I now believe that they have Moon, I really want to get swamped with this Mire, or potentially get swamped with the Mire, so I'm just gonna wait one more turn here. Yeah, this is totally fine. It does cut off, it does cut off Endurance and Blood Ghast, but I can discard both of those and Seasoned Pyromancer, and my opponent doesn't have a blue mana up. Had some awkward Cocos today. They can bolt this Grist. Yikes. Really bad Coco. But I get to resolve a Grist here. They can't force a negation of this. Ayaka's not too bad either. We're in fine shape. If my opponent goes Snapcaster, Target Bolt, I don't think I'll Endurance. But I might as well leave it up. It is nice that they can't Charm. Yeah, this Blood Moon doesn't seem to be that good for them here. Yeah, we've had some pitiful collecting companies. Yeah, I just have a second Grist in my hand. I don't think I'm supposed to pitch Endurance here. Or a third Grist, rather. Pretty good exchange for us. If I didn't have this, I probably would have pitch the Endurance. Oh, I shouldn't have played my land first. Get punished if you mill over Blood Ghast. Milled over Seasoned Pyromancer, though, which is definitely some nice added value. I think I'll not attack with an insect this turn. Don't really want them to kill this insect and then get in for. If they have two more burn spells, They get a little bit more value, a little bit more value out of it by getting to kill an insect and kill the grist. Really small margin, but also attacking for one is also a really small margin, and keeping the grist alive does feel like a priority, since my opponent can, you know, win this game with Murktide Regent, and they're gonna have a hard time winning this game without it. And I only have one more grist in the deck after this one goes. Hopefully it doesn't go. They have four cards in their hand. They definitely have options. They're tanking pretty hard. Who do we think those options are? They maybe have a Snapcaster. They might have two burn spells, and they're trying to figure out the best way to put them. Yeah, I feel like the cards to be considering are like two burn spells, Snapcaster Mage, something like that. Maybe Murktide, but Murktide is like, there's no way they play Murktide without dealing, at least dealing damage to Grist. Petty Theft, the token I'm using to block the Snapcaster. Okay, this doesn't seem to be too impactful. I can cast Endurance or Bloodgast if I get to stick the Noble Hierarch. Let me just start off by casting Seasoned Pyromancer. I think tapping like this, discard Bloodgast Kirksa. They're pausing again. Do they have double Petty Thefts? Like they would just bounce both tokens. Kill this, make a treasure. Deal. So we didn't draw a land for Bloodgast. We did draw some good ones. Trying to figure out if I should dash Ragavan. I think that I will not. Sorry. Maybe I should have just cast it. It's kind of bad if they bolted. I don't get to play the Hierarch though. But then they just get to bolt the Hierarch. Not sure. Yeah, maybe dashing was better. Still a very good turn for us. And I like that we can potentially cast this Endurance. Can potentially cast the Kroxa next turn. The Grist is really hard for them to deal with too. They scour targeting themselves. Is this Fury? I don't know what this is. Maybe it's a Murktide, like a smaller Murktide? Yeah. I think they have a step two. So I'll kill this one. They might actually just be dead to my bombardment, but. Yeah, there's just no point. Yeah, they shouldn't attack there. Because then they let Ragavan through. Oh, how much is this minus? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Remember count Grist. 9? Yeah, they're dead. Extra damage with the Kirksa. Oh, they're super dead. We just attack first before we minus the Grist. Yeah, I almost just kind of, you know, instinctively, of course, killed the Murktide with Grist, because that's basically almost always what you do. With Grist. But don't forget the minus. The minus can deal huge chunks of damage to this deck. We've been able to get them to negative five. Pretty interesting match. Hopefully we can finish off the 4-1. See you guys in that round. Okay, we are on the draw for the last match of this league. Playing against an Alluris deck, I'm going to keep this hand. 3 out of 5 matches of the league of Alluris, but they are all... No, we lost it. No, one of them was Hammer Time. That was our one loss of this league. And I don't. I guess this hand isn't particularly good against Hammer Time either. Yeah, if we were on the play, things would be pretty different, where they probably don't cast the Sigarda's Aid and they leave them in my back to block the Ragavan, and then Bombardment and Mayhem Devil are so much more likely to be able to control this game. But here, if they just, like... I guess if they put Hammers on the Midmite, actually... Yeah, it's maybe not that bad. That could just be Copium. Okay, so I can go Goblin Bombardment. If they have Hammer, they'll respond with Hammer on the Midmite. But I think that I think I'm just not going to play around Hammer. It's way better for me if to just Exalted. They can't block effectively, and then I get to play Bombardment. Or they Chump Block. Yeah, like I think both of these things are better for me here. Chump Block is like pretty nice with this drum is. Seems to be instrumental for them. So that ended up working out pretty well. I'm going to fetch a Blood Crypt here, and then... Well, think about how we're sequencing this turn. I feel like I need to get Bombardment into play. Maybe not. So we attack with Ragavan, they make a construct, they block. Then they make a construct, and they get a Hammer with Sigarda's Aid. Not really in great shape. Let me play Seasoned Pyromancer. If I draw Green Source, Hierarch, it's pretty good. I'm going to discard second Bombardment, second Seasoned Pyromancer. Yeah, then a land is fine too. I guess I maybe shouldn't have played my Mountain yet. Obviously, if they just take this, it's really good for us because we get to play the Bombardment and then the game kind of just ends. Okay, I really thought that they would make a token, but this is great for us. Yeah, this should probably translate to maybe not a win, but we're definitely in. I think I will kill the construct now, and then they have this decision of they could make another construct, but that uses basically all their mana for the turn, or almost all their mana. And then I can kill it now. I think I have to kill it now. I know this lets them get like Ornithopter instead of Hammer. Let that damage resolve just in case they flash in a equipment. So floating a mana, their Saga trigger resolves. They decide to get a Colossus Hammer, which might indicate pure steel paladin, but they don't have Metalcraft. But they do if they have a zero mana artifact creature. Which they don't. So I feel like they never make this trade. They made the trade. I guess I should Spyro. Gives me a bit better control over the field. Back Bloodghast. They might be dead next turn. They've dealt themselves a lot of damage with the silent clearings too. Although I don't want them to be able to hammer up their Stoneforge Mystic. So I think I want to kill it with the trigger on the stack. Definitely make sure the damage resolves one at a time, because if they respond with a hammer here, we'll want to ping again. And I think this is a pretty common way this matchup plays out, that you're just able to get your engine with bombardment going, and you kill all their creatures before they're able to get their engine going. And because of that, play draw does matter a lot. But it's not the... kind of weird for them to cast the Shadow Spear. But it's not the only thing that matters, I should say. But I think we have Leap Bowl. I haven't counted, but I think we've got like, I think we could get them to like -3 or -4. Because we get to attack with the Blood Gas. Maybe even more than that. Attack them for 5, down to 5, and then we deal 6, 8 more. So yeah, exactly -3. Wow. Yeah, I was right even though I hadn't done the math. I have played a lot of this deck though. I've kind of gotten a lot of the common play patterns. Or a lot of the board states kind of committed to memory, I guess. Alright, so let me re-sideboard how we had earlier. This was my plan. I think I'm going to stick with it. I don't necessarily love the second Arena 6 on the draw. I think I like it more than the other options. Arena 6 is pretty good against them. It's pretty good. They've got like 8 one toughness creatures. You guys want to keep this? You got sideboard cards. Yeah, let's keep this. Maybe I want second Ragavan. Yeah, let's keep second Ragavan over the Outer Earth, actually. Let's mold to 5. It's good for us. Ink Moth, no other one drop. Yeah, with them mold to 5, I'm pretty happy to trade Ragavan for anything. It's also nice seeing Ink Moth Nexus. This means they're not going to be able to cast Sanctifier on turn 2, probably not any sooner than like 3 or 4. So they just get basic Swamp, cast Bombardment. They don't have a third land. Yeah, they if you just don't have the third land, you can't activate Saga. Kind of a anticlimactic end, my opponent just having a non-functional hand. We went 4-1. I think this was a pretty good showcase of the deck. I don't think I played perfect. I mentioned this, I think, at some point in the video, but I'm recording this after like a 6.5-hour stream, so my brain is a little fried. I've been talking all day. Usually I record on Sunday, but I had some plans on Sunday I could record then. But I think this is a good showing of the deck. I really like the strategy. I think it's very competitive, and I've been finding a lot of success with it. Maybe more so than like almost any other deck I've been playing lately. But it is really one that rewards a lot of like patience and testing and understanding the deck. Where when I was first playing it, I really struggled to play it perfectly. And it is one of the harder decks, I think, in the format to play perfectly as well. So definitely give it some reps if you're interested in the archetype before you give up on it. But again, it's one I recommend. But I'll stop rambling. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you guys next week.